You found Francis again in a charity shop in London, it seems. Do you think you found him or he found you? My name is Joost Joustra, and I'm the co-curator of the exhibition Saint Francis of Assisi at the National Gallery, in which we are standing right now.
I'm Arun Ghosh. I'm a clarinettist and composer, and I set Saint Francis of Assisi's work, The Canticle of the Sun, to music last year. It's beautiful to be here in the National Gallery, surrounded by the most amazing pieces of art as part of this exhibition, and also the sounds of birdsong, and it's great to be here.
Arun. We're standing here in front of Zurbarán's Saint Francis in Meditation, one of the great masterpieces of the Spanish 17th century, and one of the most loved works in the National Gallery's collection. But before we look at that, can you tell us a little bit more about the Canticle of the Sun and how it came to you?
Saint Francis came up with the Canticle of the Sun towards the end of his life, and he sang it into existence. And in the Canticle of the Sun, he's singing in praise of the sun, the moon and the stars, so the astral kind of things, of earth, of wind, water. It's in praise of nature. And then in the second half, he's talking about faith, peace, devotion, and also death. And when I heard about the Canticle of the Sun, I just knew I needed to put it to music. The way I found out about it was very special. I mean, St. Francis had always been important to me. Growing up, we had Irish neighbours. They were Catholic and cared about St. Francis very much. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace was displayed in our house as well. My father was a big fan of St. Francis. So I've always been drawn to him. And I discovered a very lovely book by coincidence, looking in Tottenham Court Road, I was looking for Dante's Inferno.
Yeah.
and I found heaven and peace instead, you know. And it's depictions of Saint Francis in art. And when I was reading about that, it talked about the Canticle of the Sun and how he also sang one of the last stanzas, Death, right on his deathbed. When I read about it, I just thought I need to know more about this. When he was singing, talking in praise of nature, and particularly the sun, I connected to it in terms of Indian music, in terms of Sufi music, Qawwali, also in terms of spiritual jazz, such as the music of Sun Ra. And all of that just came to me, and I just thought, I really need to set this. And then when I came to read the words and found how beautiful they were, both in the English translation and later when I read them in the original Umbrian, I understood that these were songs already.
Yeah.
And so the Umbrian text just led itself so beautifully to be set to music.
Because not many people know that probably, but St. Francis, during his lifetime, if you read the sources, it seems he was always singing, he was always making music. And the Canticle of the Sun, appears to be one of the very first texts that was written in the Italian language, the Umbrian dialect, so not in Latin. It seems to have been a text that was accessible and available to people, but it has always existed as a text after St. Francis died, because the music got lost. So you had the words, but not the music. How did you start thinking about that?
The way I compose, especially if I'm setting songs, is I'll sit at the piano and I'll read the words and I'll almost just try and sing them and play them. Especially in the Umbrian, you can really feel the flow, the meter of it. And melody just naturally came out of it. It really did. I mean, I suppose my way into music is through melody.
Yeah.
It just really felt that that melody just brought these words out. Of course, then each one of the different sections, whether it's the sun, the moon and the stars, water, fire, all of those, I turned all of those into different songs. And so the nature of the style of the music was how I also then felt about that as thematically. Fire is almost like this raw energy punk song, you know, whereas water has this kind of Malian, almost desert music feel, where I imagined kind of people walking for water, as my family also did in India, you know. And the purity of water is like really expressed in this flowing kind of West African rhythm. Other things almost come more from a gospel or church philosophy in terms of the music, and other things are just almost my sense of melody. And then I set it for a spiritual jazz ensemble with bass, drums, and of course vocals. And it was lovely to work with two wonderful singers.
Here we are actually standing in front of a painting, an image of Saint Francis, or at least an image how someone in the 17th century imagined Saint Francis. Mm-hmm. When you look at this and you think back about the Canticle of the Sun and the music you wrote, how does that shape your thinking about Saint Francis?
When I look at this painting of Saint Francis in meditation, I feel I understand him in prayer. He spent his life in prayer. In meditation, the fact that we can't see his eyes towards the end of his life, he was blind. He wasn't necessarily writing, he wasn't necessarily seeing, he was imagining and conceiving and feeling. And yet, the face is drawn upwards to heaven, to God, it feels. The mouth is open in wonder or in kind of middle of an incantation. The humility and the purity of who he was comes through in terms of his habit. The hands clasped in prayer, you know, it's all there. And then it feels like the skull is obviously so central to the painting. We have kind of St. Francis depicted with a skull. It's that approaching death. It's that sense of how life is just temporary. And it feels that rather than having it at a distance or at his side, he's clasping it.
He's embracing it.
He's embracing it and accepting it. That, as a concept, has given me a huge amount of comfort, you know, in recent years through COVID, and then bereavement. I lost my father at the start of COVID. Writing the Canticle of the Sun, and specifically writing death, which in some ways is the climax of how we set the work. I really feel that I've accepted death as well, and through that acceptance has come what I feel is an understanding of life and an enjoyment of life and an acceptance of who I am and who we are. And I suppose this is really embodied in a painting like this that really almost captures who Saint Francis was, you know.
And works of art can do that. They can capture these feelings and these emotions in music and in images. Mm-hmm. Francis wrote the Canticle of the Sun during the last 2 years of his life, when he was in very ill health. Mm-hmm. He knew he was approaching death, and yet, like you said, he talks about death as sister death, as if he's already has a sort of a loving relationship with this very difficult subject. Mm-hmm. someone who wrote about this exhibition said the words that you don't have to believe to believe in Saint Francis. And I think there's a truth in this. He seems to unite many different people from many different backgrounds.
I think so. I mean, I think thinking about my father, who grew up in a rural village in West Bengal and came to the UK in the 60s, for him to have been introduced to St. Francis through kind of being here in this country, and for him to really kind of have had a strong resonance with him is totally sums that up, what you're saying. I mean, I think the message is universal. It clearly is. For me, I do have a faith, and I think it really resonates for me, but I think for people who don't necessarily have the same sort of faith, I think still they are part of the world, and they are part of nature, and I mean, what's there not to like, really? I think everything he says is very, very deep and powerful and pure.
May I end on something, perhaps slightly provocative, but you found Francis again in a charity shop in London, it seems. Do you think you found him or he found you?
This certainly came to me. I think whilst I didn't necessarily know about all these amazing works of art, I had thought about Lord, make me an instrument of thy peace a lot. And I thought about the Sermon to the Birds. Those things, from probably from school days, you know, have stayed with me. So I think that he's always just kind of been there. And then just at the right moment, when maybe I was ready to sort of write something new, to express something different, this came. I think kind of, as you said, it was written 800 years ago. Next year is the 800th anniversary of the writing of it. I really enjoy performing it very much. So I'm glad it all happened.
So am I. Thank you, Arun.
All right, my pleasure.